Once again, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Investor Show. As always, this is your host, Prince Dykes, coming to you guys and girls live all the way from the beautiful state of Denver, Colorado. Don't forget to hit that like, subscribe, comment, and share button. And always check out the description box to follow all our great stuff. And don't forget to share the video. And as always, I don't have a lot of time, and I definitely know you guys and girls don't have a lot of time, so we're going to jump straight into it. So as you can see in the description box, this video is going to be about stocks with 25 years of rising dividends. Now, Prince, why is that important? Why should I care about that, all that good stuff like that? Well, first, I'm going to show you a list of 25, you know, stocks, not 25, but stocks with 25 years of rising dividends or more. Some got 40, some are 50. They're called dividend aristocrats, which, you know, why this is important, because companies that can consistently pay out dividends for over 25 years, that means that we have experienced recessions and not depressions, but we have some recessions and we have some market crashes that have happened throughout those 25 years. And these companies were still able to not only pay to their shareholders, but continuously rise their dividends. Well, first of all, people love dividends because, heck, we all love dividends, right? Every investor loves dividends, residuals, things like that. But the thing about it, when a company can pay out dividends consistently over a long period of time, that speaks volumes about their financial stability. That means that a company has the financial stability to be able to pay out dividends in a down economy, which is, you know, very paramount to an investor to know, hey, guess what? We're going to experience another economical downturn. Who knows when? If you do know, please feel free to email me. But anyway, it's a website called SureDividend.com. There's plenty of other websites out there. They compiled a list for 2019 of companies that are in the S&P 500 that has at least paid dividends over the last 25 years. Not just paid, but raised their dividends over the last 25 years. And they have an Excel spreadsheet that you can, a pretty handy dandy Excel spreadsheet that you can download with all your ticklers, all of the companies' names, all of the prices, all of the dividends, the dividends yield that they're currently paying, the market cap and the PE ratio, and also the payout ratio and the beta. The beta is compared to S&P 500, kind of telling you how volatile a company is. And usually companies that pay heavy dividends, they're not that very volatile. They grow slow over time. So that's the beta. The payout ratio is when a company makes its earnings, let's say it makes $400 billion in a year in revenue, how much of that does it pay back to its shareholders in dividends? That's your payout ratio. The PE ratio in this column here is the price to earnings ratio. This is a, you know, the price of the stock compared to its earnings. This is a key indicator of people being able to find undervalued stock. The lower the PE ratio, usually the more undervalued the stock is, whereas the higher the PE ratio, the more overvalued the stock is. The key with PE ratios is that you must use PE ratios with, compare PE ratios to companies that are in that sector. So, for prime example, I wouldn't compare an Apple to a Ford. I would compare a Ford to a GM, or I would compare an Apple to maybe a Microsoft. So, companies that are in that sector. Next, market cap is market capitalization, how big the company is, how much it is worth with this stock, the value of the stock versus the price of the stock, and how many shares it has out there. So, you know, usually the larger the company is, you have large cap, mid cap, small cap. The larger the company is, the more, pretty much the bigger it is, and the more less likely, or the more volatile, and the more the less likely that it will go away. Like Apple is a $1 trillion company. The likelihood of it being gone in 5 years is pretty slim compared to a small cap, micro cap stock that's, you know, only worth maybe 10 million. Technology company that's worth 10 million versus Apple with a market cap of $1 trillion. So 5 years from now, that $10 million technology company could be gone, or it could be the next who knows what. So market cap. So dividend yield is how much this company is currently paying compared to its stock price. You got a whole list here. The price of the stock, you know, that moves every day. But here you have the name of the company and the ticker. So let me show you where you can get that from. So SureDividend.com, it has a 2019 Dividend Aristocrats list, 25 years of rising dividends. And you can download that sales spreadsheet from here. They pick companies out of S&P 500 and things like that. But, and you know, you can download it and whatnot. I'm not connected to these guys. It's not anything that is sponsored by them. It's just they have a great resource. So I thought I'd just share it. But another good resource is also the ETF, NOBL Pro Shares. This is Aristocrat ETF. So when you have a long list of stocks, you're like, okay, what am I going to do with this? Am I going to buy each and every one of these stocks or whatnot? Well, you could, or you can pick out some particular stocks. And the thing I noticed about those stocks on that list, the sidebar a little bit, is that they're all companies that are kind of recession-proof. For prime example, they are things that people are going to use even if the economy was to crash tomorrow. People are still going to brush their teeth. I hope so. Shampoo. People are going to use shampoo, toiletries, brush their teeth, probably buy soda, use utilities, you know, food, you know, lights, water, gas. Those companies all kind of fall into that, you know, we're still going to eat food, season our food, like you got McCormick's on there. You have all these type of companies that fall into that that arena some type of way. All their products are like things that I can see myself, if 2008 or 2000 was to happen tomorrow, I will still be, you know, shopping for, going to the store for, and things like that. So all these companies kind of fall into that. Johnson & Johnson is another one. So these are companies that are, you know, pretty recession. I won't say recession proof, but even in a down economy, even in a recession, I can still see people utilizing. But the thing about it is, if you don't want to go through there and pick out of stocks and pick out this company, that company, whatever, like Coca-Cola and AT&T and things like that, you also have your, you also have an ETF. The ETF is NOBL, which I have pulled up here, which is a ProShare S&P 500 Dividend Aristocrat ETF, where as in its goal is to all the companies that it is tracking, you will see that they are companies that are that have been paying dividends for over the past 25 years consecutively, and some of the companies have done it for more than that. Like for prime example, 3M has paid dividends for 50, increasing dividends for 56 years. Coca-Cola, all these companies you see here, Johnson & Johnson, Procter & Gamble, all these companies you can see here in this little category here, 50 plus years. As of 2018 that have been paying dividends consecutively, they're in here as well. So it pays a yield of 1.75. I'm not saying that, hey, you can go buy this. This is just giving you resources. This is education, not a recommendation of like, hey, this is what I can do because, you know, when we have the next down economy, high quality companies are going to be the ones that's going to make it through the hard, rough times. So, just put some tools for your toolbox. The Dividend Aristocrats, you got some ETFs here, or you can pick out individual companies. These are companies for all my dividend heads out there, dividend fiends, or whatever you want to call yourself. But anyway, hopefully you can add this to your toolbox. Hopefully this video will help you out. And to the next video, podcast, cartoon, or whatever else you see me do crazy around the globe, peace, be safe, I'm out, and thank you.